Welcome to this lesson. I'm now going to cover the key business benefits of cloud computing. Now, we have gone over some benefits of cloud already quite a few times, I think, but I want to go into a bit more detail. So AWS have something they call the six advantages of cloud computing. So that's what I want to cover in this lesson. The first one is to trade capital expense for variable expense. So in other words, you're trading capital expenditure, CapEx, to OpEx, operational expenditure. So CapEx is things like purchasing servers, whereas OpEx is things like paying on an ongoing basis for what you use, so your monthly bill. CapEx is typically tax deductible over a specific depreciation lifetime. It's a bit different in different countries. Whereas with OpEx, it's typically deductible fully in the actual year that you make that expense. So OpEx is often preferred by many organizations. That's not always the case. Some organizations have structured themselves in a way that they have budgets using capital expenditure. So IT departments find themselves preferring using CapEx. But in many cases, OpEx is a better model to use. The second advantage is to benefit from massive economies of scale. So what this really means is that because AWS is so big, and they have so many customers, and as you can see in this list, this is just a few of their premium customers, companies like Coca-Cola, Tata Motors, Vodafone, we've got Netflix on here, AOL. So lots of big companies with very large demands. So by servicing these customers and many, many more, thousands of customers around the world, AWS have huge economies of scale through their purchasing power and also through the efficiencies that they gain from having such a large platform. So the aggregated usage across hundreds of thousands of customers basically equates to a lower variable cost for the customers of AWS. The third advantage is to stop guessing capacity. So this is something that most IT teams will be very familiar with. We have a circle here indicating what you thought you needed, and then what you really needed is in green. Now, this is very common across the IT landscape. I've been into many customers where their utilization is extremely low. 15% utilization is not uncommon. And that means that the rest of the resources are sitting there idle. They're not being used. They're wasted money. Technologies like virtualization can, in some cases, really help with that unused capacity. But even then, we find that customers have lots and lots of unused capacity, even in their virtualization clusters. And it's normally because they need that capacity to scale, or at least they think they do. And people often overestimate what they need when they first actually launch a new service. So they buy too much hardware and a lot of it goes to waste. With AWS, this doesn't happen. We don't end up with this huge amount of wasted resources because it's easier to right size. So in other words, to make sure that our systems, our services on AWS have the right amount of capacity. Because it's so elastic and easy to change, we can always make sure that we can adapt as we need more and adapt again when we need less. The fourth advantage is to increase speed and agility. So in other words, speed means to deploy resources easily and quickly. It's so easy with AWS using the API, the command line, or the management console to get your resources deployed. Agility is the ability to react to change. Speed to market is really important here. It means you can get your services to market faster because you're better able to react to changes, update, make changes as you need to, and deploy your applications. The fifth advantage AWS mentions is to stop spending money running and maintaining data centers. So if you have on-premise infrastructure, that's a lot of money that you can be spending on those data centers. And that money does not get spent on AWS. You can put your money to services that add more value to your business. So when you decrease your data center management costs, you really can increase your innovation. Why do you want to spend money actually managing a data center, which is fairly low value? It's not increasing the value of the offering that you're bringing to market to your customers. So you can now spend that money instead of on data centers on innovation. And that means that you can be more competitive and bring better value to your customers. The last advantage here is to go global in minutes. We looked at how you can do this with the 24 regions and tools like AWS CloudFormation, where you can deploy your applications all over the world very, very quickly. That's something you just could not do before the cloud. It could take months, even years, to set up an infrastructure where you have applications in many different parts of the world. So now you can do that literally in minutes. If you've got your code ready, you can deploy it straight away. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next lesson.